Sometimes calluses are pretty diffuse and they don't cause us much pain, and sometimes they can be very localized or right in a weight-bearing area and can be really painful to walk with. This gentleman has had these calluses for many years, and to look at them, it had to feel like he had a little pebble embedded in his skin all the time. So hopefully I was able to give him some relief, and hopefully we'll be able to get these not to be so bad in the future. So who else in your family has calluses like these?
Mama, when she used to, they just amputated her legs.
Oh no, she diabetic?
Yeah, no, she got blood clots.
Oh.
And then it led to a lesion, and then the lesion led to something else. Man.
Oh, where's your mommy?
She's in Chicago. My niece is taking care of her now. She's supposed to move up here, but she's talking about it's too cold. I was like, it's the same as Chicago.
It's the same as Chicago with less wind.
Yeah. But you know how folks get set in their ways.
I do.
Plus, you want to stay there and be grandma of the century. But I told her, you see, you deal with your granddaughter, or it's going to be assisted living because you don't want to come to Minnesota. And that was before the pandemic, of course. I had a room for her and everything.
Yeah. Now, is your wife still in the house or no?
Yeah, she's still in there.
Oh, okay.
We take care of her mom, too. I was like, you can come up here and get the same thing, same treatment as her mom. All she gotta do is wake up and go to sleep. Everything else taken care of. I cook, and the wife trained her and all that stuff. But like I said, she set in her ways.
Yeah, we're all kind of that way, aren't we?
Yeah, I know. That's why I don't argue. I know I wouldn't want to pack up if 75 and go to another state. But if it's for the better, and that's what I couldn't understand, this thing on the bottom of my foot, that was really painful. But the two things on the side was like Shrek. They take the cake and the ice cream.
Yeah, these are called cutaneous horns.
Oh wow. So everybody get them or just
no,
just the lucky one?
You're one of the lucky ones, but it just means that it's a callus that grows kind of in the shape of a horn.
I tried to put some of that liquid stuff on there, but...
Yeah, don't use that.
Don't.
That is,
acid.
Yes. Yeah. It's a salicylic acid. Yeah, and it'll burn a hole in your skin. In fact...
Yes, it will.
I just have a patient right now in my clinic where we're going to have to amputate the toe because they burned a hole in it.
I know. That's serious.
Yeah, it got infected and the bone's infected now.
Oh.
Because they were using that salicylic acid liquid on the callus.
No.
And just went too far. So, what I was saying before is these are going to continue to come back.
Yeah.
And so for as long as you're here, you're welcome to come every month that we come, and I can trim these down.
Oh, wonderful.
Maybe over time we can get them to be a little smaller.
Yeah.
And,
I was just in the hospital. I was supposed to see the podiatrist, but he was backed up all the way to March, I think.
Oh, do you want to know something?
Mm-hmm.
You've got your own personal podiatrist right here.
I see.
You didn't even have to do it in the hospital. She came all the way over here to see you.
I see. I told you y'all ain't
doing this. It was your Christmas gift from God to you.
I'm not a gift from God.
Yes, you are.
I was walking like I was walking on thumbtacks.
Well, I can see why this would feel that way. It would be like you're walking with a piece of gravel in your skin.
Yeah, you described it exactly.
Yeah.
And then I had the nerve to be shaking out my shoes like it was really something.
Yeah, so I think what I'll do is next next month when I come, I'm going to bring you a cream that's going to help keep this softer. Again, they're going to keep coming back, but if we can manage them, then you won't have the kind of pain you're having now.
Oh, wonderful.
Okay.
I'm trying to put on shoes with these things. I have to stretch the shoe out to the side and all that.
Yeah.
My sister kept telling me, she was like, you're gonna regret letting your feet get like that because you walk on them every day.
Well, but of course you walk on them every day. That's what they're for.
Yeah.
You know, and this isn't anything you could have helped. This is just your genetics.
Let's
go the other side.
Working. Yep, got it.
All right, so let's get this one. You let me know if anything I'm doing is hurting, okay?
No.
Does that hurt when you walk?
Yeah, I'm actually going to put a new blade on.
When you walk, does that side hurt right here?
Yeah, it depends on what shoes I have on or boots. And that's when they bump it up, rubbing up against the boot or the shoe.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's pretty painful.
And don't let me forget, there's one down here I gotta get before we're done.
Well, I got three of them, four, five. Wow. Are they easy?
Those are a long time coming. You have been building these up for a long time.
And I've been trying to put that liquid stuff on it. It seemed like that Callus look at it and laugh.
Yep.
You gotta come better than that, G. But I'm glad you told me, doctor, because I was putting a lot on it, too.
Yeah, what that stuff does is, you know, it's supposed to, like, chew all the thick skin up and turn it to mush.
Yeah.
But if you don't have a really good view of what you're doing, and this would be a very difficult spot
exactly.
to see,
exactly.
you don't know when it's going too deep. And then if you go too deep, it'll eat away the good skin underneath, and then you'll have scars.
I can't afford that.
Right.
Seeing I can make up enough noise by itself. Pain.
Yeah.
Don't need no extras. Already.
You're giving my blades a run for their money, man.
I told them they say the best will last.
Oh, look at that. It left like a big hole right there.
Oh, gosh. That's got to be painful.
Just stick a straw in it. Not.
Yeah.
I'll figure out something to do with it.
Now, even when you were working as a cook and standing on your feet all day, these had to be horrible.
Yes.
Have you had these most of your life?
Yes.
Okay.
Well, I had a wood, what you use on woods, a little...
An axe?
Drill gun thing. Where I could
a Dremel.
Yeah.
Yes, that's what she'll use to smooth this when she's done.
And that worked until my grandson... broke it.
Yep.
Like, how do you break a drill?
If you leave it to a boy, they'll figure it out.
I know, I see. I was like, how do you break a whole industrial drill? I don't know, Granddad. I did it, though. I ain't gonna blame it on my brother. He's like, well, you did good.
Wow, you won't believe your feet.
I believe that. If I know it feels better already.
Yeah, get all that pressure off.
Yes. I take a shower.
You're going to wake up at night, in the middle of the night tonight, you're going to wake up and you're going to think, my feet. Whose feet are these on my body?
Yeah.
Because they will feel so different.
Yeah, because calluses like this, I would imagine they would throb.
Yes, and then when I try to get up in the middle of the night and run to the bathroom, it seems like they get worse. Especially with house shoes on. And then I'm kind of flat-footed, so I just can't win.
Yeah.
You're a pretty tough dude, though.
I got to be.
Some people just give up.
No, I ain't giving up. I'm too old for that.
I love that attitude.
All right.
You gotta keep on hopping, because as soon as you give up, that's when they have them funeral.
Let's see down here, too.
So you said that even though they laid you off, that you still have your insurance?
Yes.
All right, then I'm going to give you a prescription for this cream so you don't have to wait until next month.
Oh, okay. Wonderful.
To start using it, and I just happened to bring my prescription pad with me today.
Wonderful.
So I'll write you a prescription, and that will help, and then I do want to see you back next month.
You want me to come?